Welcome to a new planetary and seismic update. In the previous update, I marked the 20th to the 22nd as more critical due to the lunar conjunctions that we had on the 20th. Later on the 20th, a magnitude 6.3 earthquake occurred in the Turkey-Syria border region. This is not an aftershock, it occurred a little bit to the south, and this is because of the stress distribution around the Arabia Plate. There are significant changes since the major earthquakes on 6 February. I also estimated that the seismic activity could peak around the 22nd. This is the rule of thumb that I explained in the previous update, that we add about 2 days and then give or take 1 day. And last night, a magnitude 6.8 earthquake occurred in Tajikistan and it was widely felt in surrounding countries. This is what we can have. This is a typical seismic response to lunar geometry converging like we had on the 20th. Let's have a look at the planetary and lunar geometry in the last week of February. On the SSGI graph, we see a purple peak. This is one planetary conjunction on the 24th, and it is followed by a lunar conjunction early on the 25th. Overall, the last week of February doesn't look too critical. Let's have a look at the solar system. The planetary conjunction is with the Sun, Venus, and Uranus. That is later on the 24th. I marked that with the red line. And it is followed by a lunar conjunction also with Uranus, and it is early on the 25th. And I marked that conjunction with the green line. This is sort of a convergence on the 24th, 25th, and we could see some seismic increase as a result, probably around the 25th, 26th. It may not be all that much, but that would be the time, 25th, 26th roughly, to be a bit higher alert. I also want to take a quick look at the first week of March. There will be significant planetary and lunar geometry. On the 2nd, around the 2nd of March, we see a clustering of critical planetary geometry. And also on the 4th and 5th, we could see a significant seismic increase, some strong seismic events as a result in the first week of March. I will go into much more detail about the first week of March in one of the next updates. So stay tuned. If we look at atmospheric fluctuations that we had in the last couple of days, only one significant fluctuation actually occurred and was over the West Pacific. It marked regions east of Kamchatka and also South Japan, that is the Izu Islands, the Bonin Islands, and then further south, the New Guinea region. It's the only significant atmospheric fluctuation that we actually recorded. It could be significant for the last week of February, possibly around the 25th, 26th. It could also become significant in the first week of March. This is the information that we have so far. Stay safe. Until next time.